That's why I'm here.
Play the fourth string. Third. First. You play very well. I don't know about the violin. Would you do me a favor?
Of course.
Would you play this?
Gladly.
What are you doing in the water if you don't know how to swim?
I told you to wait for me.
Why should I wait for you? Now, take those clothes off, you young idiot. Can't you hear your teeth chattering? Come on, take them off. And heaven help you if you wet my salt.
What is it? Let me see it.
Now you've seen it.
How do you do it? Show me how you do it. I want to get off.
Do you now? You'll get off when we arrive. All I can do for you is to bring you back. But that won't be until the day after tomorrow. Tomorrow I have business in Cremona.
Where's Cremona? My parents were from Cremona.
And where are they now?
They're not anywhere. They're dead.
Thank you.
Brother Gabriel, I have something for you.
What's your name, young man?
Clamore, compressione, dentium,
dentium.
Preferium vero contraction
politics. You too! That's enough! Stop it! You hear me? Stop it, you brats! Clean your hands. You two again! You horrible little beasts! Who are you?
He's a new boy, sir. He comes from the country. He's a boarder.
I didn't ask you. Can you read? You. Boy. You. Come here. Let me hear you.
I'll show him the place.
R, L, D, R, L, D, R.
Help our orphan children, and God will help you.
Brother, have pity on poor
Pescaroli, Pax Vobiscum.
I did as you said, brother. My wife's pains have not gone away.
Tried this. Found mint from our garden.
Come, I'll show you something. You see that? That's what I'm gonna do when I grow up.
A small offering, good people.
It no longer has the same tone.
I suspect there's the beginning of a crack under the soundpost. Nice. It must have received quite a blow. Play again. I'm afraid we must replace the back. But it might affect the resonance.
Did you make it?
Certainly I made it.
Can you play them?
Of course.
Well, I'll soon learn anyway.
Have you gone off your head? Now you'll catch it.
Pax vobiscum.
Now listen, before I start playing, I need one of those things that you know how to make.
All I know is how to soak the ribs before they're bent.
Hey! Shh!
Laudate Dominum de Celis! Laudate Deum in Excelsis!
Hey!
Laudate Deum Excelsis! Laudate Deum Excelsis! Laudate Deum Alleluia! Laudate Deum Excelsis!
Quia ipse dixit facta sum, ipse mandavit et
vitam intellectualem cum solis angelis dedit, a quest omnis modus, omnis species, omnis ordo, a quest mensura numerus pondus, a quest quid naturaliter est, quisquamque generis est, cuius libet estimationis est, quid edit et carni originem pulcritudinem valetudinem propagationis fecunditatem membronum dispositionum salutem concordie, quiet anime in rationali dedit memoriam sensum ad petitum rationali autem in super mentem intelligentiam voluntatem, qui non solum celum et terram, nec solum angelum et hominem, sed nex exigui et contemptibilis.
They threw it away because it had odor in it. This you must bring back tomorrow. Promise?
Mm-hmm.
Hanging outside the orphan's dormitory. They stole it in order to sell it.
Hell's bitches! Take your hands off that! I left it out so that the varnish would dry in the sun.
So it's yours, is it?
Of course it's mine.
Now tell me, my fine young fellow, where did you find it?
I didn't find it. I made it.
Well, well, well. Here. Look, look at this. Did you really make this all by yourself? Tell me, how did you manage the F-holes? I think I recognize the scroll, but...
Will you teach me to play it?
There's not much you can play on this. But if you would like to come work for me, I can teach you to make violins that sound a trifle... Violins that sound a bit better than this one. Will you let me have him? Eh? I'll teach him a craft. And I'll look after him. Oh, why do you do that?
It's no good. It's badly made. You said so yourself. It's so bad it made you laugh.
And I just offered to have you come and work for me. Considering it was made by a boy, it's really...
If it's badly made, it's badly made. It's no good. And that's it.
Careful with that wing now. Marco, shave a little off the left bit. Move that thing out of the way.
Quickly, over here with it. Come on now.
Look, Casey, if you could spare a moment, I'd...
Antonio! Isn't that the famous French violinist with Marchese Ariberti?
It could have been, what of it?
He'll try out your violin, won't he?
I suppose so.
I see.
Marchese, please, some charity for my little children.
Go on, move away.
Maestro Amati, maestro of maestros.
All right, he doesn't want to use my name. Let him sign him with his, by all means. But a supervising maestro made in the school of Niccolo Amati, that's all I ask. Even if I make the whole thing myself, as I did with the one for the Frenchman. Made in the school of. But doesn't that seem fair to you? That way, someone might at least begin to suspect that we exist. Five!
My usual luck. I have a small example of the great Amati's art.
Pay your debt, my lord.
I always pay my debts.
Never.
Do as I did. Leave. Come and work for Pescaroli with me. And as for Maestro Amati.
It's different for you. You never really liked making violins.
I never liked working like a dog for slave wages. And I never liked sleeping in a broom cupboard. True, also prefer engraving. But I'm sure you would, too. Come and talk to Pescaroli. He wants you, you know. There is more variety in the work. It pays well. And it gives you a chance to travel. There's talk now of a job in Spain. Spain! Think what a time we'd have together. And then you see the insides of great houses. Have you ever been in a palazzo?
Are you still working at Palazzo Liberti?
Yes. Come and see us there.
This for me?
No. Unless you make him happy. Look how gloomy he is.
Ah!
sia maledetto amor, sia maledetto amor, sia maledetto amor,
sia maledetto amor.
What was that for?
I'm overwhelmed by your voice. It's so, isn't it?
Oh, magisterial, Signor Marchese.
No merit of mine. Gift of the gods.
Occhi soverchi arditi che agli amorosi inviti così legger correste.
I've heard that the King of France actually dances on stage. Masked, of course.
What do you think, Pescaroli?
These bare walls deaden the sound. We must cover them with material.
Oh, no. Men are always covered with material. At least let me have the walls bare.
What I would really like to hear is an instrument.
Su questa lira!
We can't la bella clarinetta. I've sent for our guest.
Le violon du roi.
Where could I find Signor Pescaroli? Pescaroli, the architect. No. He's working in the theater.
Are you looking for something?
Encore?
It's not entirely satisfactory. Back here, there's a lack of...
Resonance.
You're
right. It's because the proscenium arch is too low. If only we could raise it...
It's not the fault of the theater. It's the fault of the violin.
Perhaps someone should inform the young man that this violin is the masterpiece of Maestro Niccolò Amati.
Do you think I don't know that? I ought to. I made it. It has a beautiful tone. But it's a beautiful tone which dies almost before it's born. It doesn't carry. It doesn't reach out. The tone should reach the heart even before it reaches the ears.
Who is this impertinent young fellow?
Please excuse him, Signor Marchese. This is Antonio Stradivari. He works for Maestro Amati. But I would like him to come and work in my workshop.
I'll go on making violins until I make one the way I want it. And then hell's bitches, perhaps you understand what I'm talking about.
They're ashamed of you, too. Francesca!
Pietro, he's killing me.
Leave her alone. Take your hands off her. You mind your own business. I told you to leave her alone.
Oh. No. For God's sake, someone help me.
Stop! Stop!
I think he's better for it. Someone go for a doctor. Doctor.
I'll fetch a doctor. You had better go for a priest, because this man is dying.
Here, lift him onto my coat. He's bleeding. Who is it? Give me a hand.
Stay where you are, all of you. Who is this man?
He's my husband, Giovanni Giacomo Capra.
Was it him?
How can I tell? It was dark. I couldn't see anything. Someone fired a shot. I don't know if it was him or not.
What do you mean you don't know? I heard people quarreling. She cried out for help. Someone was trying to kill her. I ran out to see what I could do. I saw a man.
Arrest him.
It wasn't me. I'm telling you, it wasn't me. I had nothing to do with it.
Come back here, you.
Living soul.
You come with us.
Lord of mercy, what happened? You look after them, Madeline. I'm going to fetch the priest. Papa, it's me, Francesca. Let me in. Papa, please, let me in. It's me.
Hola there! Open! In the name of his worship, the mayor of Cremona! Would you be Giovanni Fedoboschi, royal magistrate of the streets?
I would.
I see from the nameplate that this aquabus belongs to you. Someone has used it to commit a crime.
Hey, you! Get up, they want you.
Me?
You're the one with the aquabus, aren't you?
Don't be like me. Confess immediately.
I have nothing to confess. I haven't done anything.
Confess all the same.
No, that's not the man. I knew it wouldn't be.
Go away! What are you waiting for? It wasn't you! Didn't you hear him?
She involved me to try to save her lover. Her husband must have come across them like I did, kissing. And who knows what else?
You know, I don't think the Marquese's brother...
No, I don't say it was him. Well, certainly the man I saw running away wasn't as tall as that pig I saw at the palazzo. But it was that woman's lover. I'm sure of that. And if it wasn't the Marquese's brother-in-law, well, that means she has more than one. And I want to hear it from her own mouth.
Oh, you want to?
Well, certainly I do. Do you think I'm going to let that bitch get away with it just like that?
Thanks to her, I've been beaten up.
thrown into jail, treated like a dog. And if it hadn't been for her father, who probably took pity on me, they'd have strung me up.
Oh, no, she hasn't seen the last of me. And I know just where to find her, too.
You do, huh?
Yes.
Bring out the children.
Yes, sir. Can I help you?
Excuse me. Yes, I was looking for some designs for inlay work. Something happened.
A lot has happened, but the worst is over. Now they're taking away the children.
What children?
The children of Giovanni Giacomo. Terrible carpenter, poor fellow. His father, Capra, the architect, asked for custody of them, and the judge granted it. Because their mother. What sort of designs were you looking for?
Maddalena! Maddalena!
My mistress wants to talk to you. She will wait for you at the hour of the rosary in front of the chapel of Santa Maria della Pietà and Santa Agata. Please don't turn around. I let you be arrested that night to give my brother time to escape. It was he who killed my husband. Today I heard he has found refuge in Mantua. Please, I have nothing more to say. Again, I ask you to forgive me. Try not to think too badly of me. I had no choice.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Madre Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen.
Done me an injustice.
I've asked your forgiveness twice. For the third time, please forgive me.
No, it's not that. You, your brother, your father, you're all in league to cover up for somebody. Somebody important, perhaps that man I saw you with at the palazzo. You may say, what has all this to do with me? but since I am involved...
I do say, what has all this to do with you? What I told you was the truth. It was my brother. He did it to save my life. You see, I was never at all close to my husband. He was a widower with a child to raise. So he needed a woman. I was forced to marry him. I was very young, and I wanted to stay young. He wasn't like his father, who's a man of substance, respected by everybody, no. He was the family failure. Surly, mean-minded. I was miserably unhappy with him. But I never forgot how to laugh. So I soon acquired a bad reputation. Because if a man looked at me, I did everything in my power to make him look at me some more. That's as far as it went. Or very little further, anyway. You probably don't believe me, but I don't care. It's the truth. I felt so much resentment towards my husband that I encouraged others to flirt with me. And he knew it, because I did nothing to hide it from him. He used to beat me half to death. That evening, I told him I'd been to the Palazzo Ariberti. He lost control of his senses and picked up a knife. I ran away and tried to reach my father's house, but he caught up with me. My brother came down to defend me. He didn't mean to kill him, but as you know, that's what happened. And now it's even worse. It's even worse than before. Makes me laugh when I think about it, because I had sworn nothing could be worse. My father-in-law has taken the son from my husband's first marriage, and also my little girls. And I'm not allowed into his house, because my brother killed his son, and especially because of my bad reputation. My own father doesn't want to see me anymore, but he wants my brother back. The way's already been prepared. My brother asked for forgiveness. There will be a formal ceremony of pardon, after which I shall be free to go to a convent. That's right. They're sending me to a convent. I've accepted. Because that's the only way to get my brother back and make everyone happy. By shutting me away for life in a convent.
I want to marry you.
You what?
I want to marry you.
That's impossible. You're a madman. All the same, it was nice to hear you say it. Really.
I hope I'm not disturbing you, but I just thought of something and I wanted to ask you so that I'll know what to think.
What is it you want to know?
Well, Marco once showed me a little house in the parish of Santa Cecilia and told me it belonged to you, and you rented it.
That's correct. It's too small for me, so I rent it by the year.
I renewed the lease just the other day.
Well, there's no hurry because so many things have to happen first. But I wanted to know if next year you would consider renting it to me.
A year from now?
As I say, there's no hurry. But if I knew I could count on it, I could start making plans.
Make your plans by all means. But in a year's time, you won't be independent.
Don't worry. I'll see to that.
When you came in here, I thought you'd come to tell me you decided to take the big step. I haven't given up hope, you know. I'm sure you like it here. Why don't you try? I always remember how when you were a boy you made that violin because you wanted to learn to play. And that's what made you learn the craft. But perhaps one day, if you try to carve...
Don't forget about the house. In a year's time,
I'm counting on it.
Open the door! Open up!
You down there! What are you making all that noise for?
A few minutes ago, you could be nice to Simon when I knocked. No one answered.
Well, what can I do about it?
I don't know. You must know the woman who lives there, I suppose.
No, I don't.
She can't have left already. Besides, as I said, lights were on. Perhaps she's been taken ill. Hola, Signora Francesca. It's me.
What a way to behave.
Go home.
There are people inside. I know there are. Perhaps it's been an accident.
No way. Go
I'm going to break the door down. You're a witness, remember.
My mistress says you are to go away at once, or she will call the guard. Stop! No! Where do you think you're going? Signora!
Out of here! Are you drunk? Leave or I call for help. Do you want to start a scandal?
I hear the ceremony took place today and your brother was pardoned.
Yes. That's all they were waiting for. Everyone's happy now.
I want to marry you. I told you. Have you forgotten?
That was a joke. Besides, I haven't set eyes on you since.
I've waited. But I've thought of you. I've thought of everything. I've waited, and I decided.
Oh, yes. And what have you decided?
I want to marry you.
I'm just a violin maker. An apprentice. But I'm setting up on my own. My workshop. My tools. I don't want you to go to a convent.
What do you need with me? A woman with my reputation and wants to live on by your own family. Someone to treat badly. A grateful slave. Or are you so poor you can't allow yourself a decent woman for a wife? If that's it, you're making a big mistake. I have no intention of being grateful to anybody. I couldn't even see my own children. And to come here and start giving orders. It's more than I can stand.
You haven't understood a word I said.
Oh, I've understood all right. Out of here.
You won't let me talk. You won't listen. I'm no great talker. No, it's not my way.
But you are.
You know how to talk. Everything you said. Everything. It's just not true.
Leave me. Please.
Like the water of a river. It's not of my doing. It's the way the tree wanted to grow. Trees die. Wood doesn't. A voice.
voice of its own. And it has a soul. It's not bad. It's not yet the way I want it. The sound I'm always searching for. This is what I know how to do.
You don't marry a woman who has been to bed with a man, even if that man happens to be you. Look, we went back to work at the Palazzo Riberti Theater. And you know what I heard? You remember the Marchese's brother-in-law, the pig. Well, the company's been rehearsing in the theater the last few days, some opera they're taking to Venice. And his lordship has discovered there are certain things he likes doing to the accompaniment of music. So, every evening he takes his woman into a box. And now, suppose his companion was your future bride. I haven't seen her close up, but she's more or less the same height. And the way she moves.
That's enough! What do you know?
Bassoon! C natural!
Not C sharp, C natural! Ba 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 ba! Wake up! From the beginning.
Wait here. They're not here yet.
I must have time to warm up! What do you expect of me on stage? Fly, sing? It would never happen to me in Vienna, let alone Paris. And these ghastly straps, they are too narrow, too wide. I can't breathe. Maestro, please, you up there, pay attention to what you're doing. Don't hurt me like that. May I remind you, I'm not a sack of potatoes. I am the divine. stop flapping me about, you ignorant animals! You have all the delicacy of a fox with a herd of bullocks!
He was right, you lying whore!
All right, if you want to do it your way, there is nothing I can do to stop you. But remember what I said. You don't marry a woman who has been to bed with a man. Even if that man happens to be you.
Here I am. Morning.
Good morning,
Philip.
Yes, here we are. Marriage, isn't it?
Giovanni Grancini.
Warm, profound, beautiful low register. Superb design. Who's next?
Francesco Gobetti.
No. Hey, wait, wait, wait. Metallic tone. No es madera. Parece una vulgar coraza. El siguiente.
Mama.
Mama!
Did all go well?
Yes, yes, but I won't tell you a thing until you put some food in my stomach. Oh, I've done more than that. I heard that the violins had to be submitted to the town council by today, so I took it there myself.
Which one did you take?
Well, which one do you think? The one I was supposed to deliver to Milan, of course.
Merciful heavens. Your father, as much as suspected, kill you.
Huh. It's empty.
Amavano! Amavano, the door.
Hello, hi. Papa. Everything went well, only they didn't give me the money. They said a banker will be bringing it to you.
What are you doing here?
I was...
You left the door open. Go down to the workshop.
I'm hungry.
Here. Got itchy downstairs.
I'll come with you.
Wait a minute. What about the banker? No, they were supposed to give you the money.
Well, the banker travels with an escort of two armed men, so... It's safer.
It's not as if they were sending all the gold in the Indies, huh? You know what I think, Antonio?
What?
As they haven't paid you, you should take the opportunity to raise your price, seeing as how they're speculating on you anyway.
I asked for 200 golden crowns. Nobody is speculating on nobody.
That's what you say. I've heard that Guarneri has up to 400.
Oh, you heard, huh? You heard. Where? When? From whom? The woman who sells you the eggs? The man who brings the bread? Listen, please, don't chatter about things you know nothing about. You lack for anything?
I was only thinking of you. I was thinking you could have more reward for all your hard work.
Reward? More orders? I can't even finish the ones I have. Just this morning, I turned down two. Two!
Well, you shouldn't have. You should accept the orders and let yourself be helped. Francesco could easily...
Well, I've been doing this work for 40 years, and now he's going to help me? Well, that's wonderful, wonderful. Oh, maybe you can tell me how to cut the maple. In strips or in wedges? Maybe he can teach me how to make a violin for the King of Spain. Oh, son, that is fine. What are you doing here? Keep this bird out of my way.
Please, Papa.
Next time, I'm going to eat it.
Pietro Guarneri.
A noble tone, but a bit thin. It doesn't expand. Exceptional soprano register.
Come on, dite?
Soprano register. Purity of a young girl. A beautiful young girl. Doncellas que saltan entre las piedras de un arroyo. But on second thoughts, I don't like it at all. Let's hear the next.
Goffredo Cappa.
Fuerte, brillante, resonant, fine sound,
Madera buenissima. It seems to me perhaps the best we've heard up to now. Play the last one.
Antonio Stradivari.
Esmeralda! No, no! Now you're going to bed.
The house of Antonio Stradivari. Open the door.
Stay where you are. Don't move.
Antonio Stradivari, in the name of the illustrious representative of His Majesty, the King of Spain, let us into your house.
I'll go, Papa. I said stay where you are. Hello. What is this? They sent it back. What's the matter? They don't like it?
No, no. It's all right, Papa. It's for the King's Award. They're giving it to you.
In my capacity as Grand Chamberlain at the court of His Most Catholic Majesty, the King of Spain, whom God preserve. Having spoken to His Excellency, the Royal Master of Music, who during his visit to this most loyal of cities has examined and listened to violins made by diverse worthy craftsmen who have devoted their lives to creating these noble instruments, I have the honor of announcing that the award for the highest achievement will be presented to you by His Majesty in person.